Welcome back to the hottest show in the galaxy. It's the Karen Hunter Show. We're here on Sirius XM Urban View, channel 126. And I just discovered this gentleman this season because, you know, I watch How to Get Away with Murder.
All right.
And he showed up with his beautiful self. And I was like, okay. But I know he's up to no good. I know there's some nefarious things happening. And now he's also in a new Tyler Perry movie. Let me welcome to the show, Mr. Rome Flynn.
Thank you for having me.
Yes. Are you related to the Flynns, the Earl Flynn family?
No.
Are those Flynns?
Not familiar.
Not familiar?
No.
All right. So let me ask you, first of all, you show up on How to Get Away with Murder, starring Viola Davis, and now... Oh, my goodness. She plays Tegan. Wait, Amira Van.
Oh, yeah. That's my girl.
From Underground. Mm-hmm. Lord have mercy. So they have all of this going on.
Yeah.
And now you are showing up as the son of the man that got killed the first season, who was Annalise's husband. There's so much drama in this show. There's so much drama. How did you get this role?
Yeah. I auditioned. I was working with...
the way most people get roles.
It is interesting, though. I was working in Atlanta at the time. I was doing the Have and the Have Nots for Tyler Perry. And they sent me this audition. I was like, guys, there's no way. I have no time. Like, I'm working 10-hour shifts. You know what I'm saying? So they said, you got to do it. Like, this is one you need to send in. So I made it happen. One of my friends came and he taped it for me, and I just sent it in.
So that's the new way to do it. You used to have to show it to a studio and do a table read or something, and now you can just do an audition. So they sent you the script for this particular. Mm-hmm. Do you remember the scene that you...
It was a scene that wasn't a real scene.
Okay.
Yeah, they don't give out the real info when they
say
because big projects, they don't, they give you something fake.
So then, you actually look like, so there's a, for people who don't know, this season, Rome plays the long lost son of the husband that Annalise lost in the first season. That's what started all the How They Got Away with Murder, was killing him.
Yeah.
I didn't know he was married to a black woman before Annalise. So he, you know, once you go black, I guess that's true. That's all
type.
True.
I see. Type,
yeah. So there's a scene where you have a flashback and the son is actually the actor's real son.
Yeah,
so the real actor loves it in a very melanated way. And I'm not mad at him.
Oh, yeah. In real life.
In real life. And his son actually looks a little bit like you. I was like, the casting on this is amazing.
It's insane. They had they didn't write that ahead of time. Like, you know, the show's great, but like, they did not plan that out that way. It just happened to, he just happened to look like me. And then they were like, we using his real son, you know, and he had shown me his kids before. And I was like, man, he looks like he related to me. And like 3 weeks later, they like,
there you go.
Man. Yeah.
That was amazing. All right. What's been the biggest challenge of playing this role and How to Get Away with Murder before we get to Madea Family Funeral? Because I already know how that happened. All right.
The biggest challenge, was just getting out of my own way, you know, because a lot of times, you know, just it's in human nature, just, you know, we doubt ourselves all the time, you know. So I'm going into a situation where I'm working with, you know, someone like Viola Davis, who is just, she could just trip over an Emmy in her house probably, you know. So going into that, knowing that I didn't know what my character was going to be or what the storyline was going to be, but I knew it was going to be pivotal to the season. So I knew I was going to work with her closely, you know. So I guess for the first month and a half, I was like not knowing how to address her. I was like calling her Miss Davis, Miss V. You know, she was like, just call me V, it's okay. I'm like, thank you, because like I don't know how to talk to you right now, because I just respect her so much, you know. And
she's
and
iconic.
Yeah, you know, I'm so grateful. I'm humbled by it. You
has
know,
has she taught you anything? Both off, maybe just through watching.
Oh yeah,
you learned
100%. Yeah, I don't talk, I listen. You know, so when I'm in scenes with her, I let her do her thing, and I'm just picking up little things along the way. Honestly,
she's the messiest, most complicated character on television that I can't stop watching, because she's an alcoholic.
Yeah.
There's like so many complicating things with her whole character and personality, and they keep bringing her drama. And I know why
she brings
drinking.
It every time.
Like, Lord have mercy.
She brings it.
I don't know whether to like your character or not, Gabriel.
Okay.
You're cute, so that helps. You know, I was like, oh, okay, he's playing basketball, which you really do. You're a basketball player, NCAA.
I still play.
So you saying you still can play?
Is that what I can still hoop for sure. I'm by far the best basketball celebrity. Period.
Well, you know Mahershala Ali was D1. He won an Oscar again for the second year in a row. So you telling me you can take Mahershala Ali? Is that what you saying, Rome Flynn?
Man, I want the one on one.
The one-on-one. You could take Mahershala Ali, who played D1 basketball.
I would dust them little ankles off. Okay. I'll dust them off. I don't know the last time he picked up a ball, but I just hooped on Saturday.
Did you?
Yeah.
Who'd you play? Your brothers? Because that doesn't count.
No.
I think I could take one of your brothers. I promise you. Especially this one. All right.
You can hoop too. No, I got my own team. Yeah.
I'm playing. No, yeah. Really.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. NCAA is coming up. Do you have a team that you're looking at? How do you feel about Duke?
I love Duke.
Uh-huh.
What would you feel about
homie blowing out his sneakers and Nike going, oops?
That was insane.
Wasn't it?
What a strange, unfortunate events. I mean, I think that any shoe he probably would have had on would have done that. He's been playing with those shoes the entire season, though. And he's a big dude.
He's 6'8", 285?
He should have had some LeBrons on, I'll be honest. But I think that he's going to come back and play. Do you think he should?
Because he's looking at being number one pick coming out.
It's going to happen.
That's $100 million right there.
Yeah.
You tweak your knee, you know about athletes.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's not going to be right for a minute. Steph Curry is still just getting over the ankle thing, right?
Yeah, so knee is very...
Is it worth it? You need your knees. You could tape your ankles and basically...
In hindsight, probably not, honestly. I mean, considering the fact that, do you know they're charging more for Duke tickets than they are for Cavs tickets, right? So, you know what I'm saying? Just in retrospect, if you want to talk about the NCAA.
I heard it cost more for that Duke ticket than the Super Bowl.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. So, these kids ain't seeing none of that money, man. They're eating oodles and noodles. You know, he clearly busted his shoes.
I think Zion's not eating oodles and noodles.
I think he is. I think he's
slipping him a steak. I think he's getting a T-bone.
We ain't going to speak that for him.
T-bone Welch is great.
We ain't going to speak that for him. But he eating all right, I think. I think he should play, though, if he wants to play. You can't be afraid of injury. If that's the case, you ain't going to make it nowhere.
So how do you – there's no causing your contract to not play? Because you can get an elbow to the nose, and that's it.
That's a fact.
How you showing up?
You know what? It's happened, but you would never tell, because
Rome, your nose is looking a little off to the left. Well, you know,
character
I'm a thespian, and
yes,
I think my character fell down the stairs, but it wasn't written into the script. Like, how do you play that off?
You know, I don't worry about things I can't control. I give it to God, honestly.
But you can control it by not playing basketball.
But I need basketball, though.
Tell me why.
It keeps me level-headed, honestly. It's one of the things that makes sense to me. Like, when I'm on the court, I don't have to think about nothing. You know, in an industry where I'm not in control of most things. Basketball, it seems very controlled to me, and I understand it more than anything. So I need that. Without that, I'll be going crazy.
Did you ever think that you could play professionally?
Yeah,
I know
I could play
in
right
your
now.
Mind, but I'm saying, like, in reality.
Yeah, I could play right now.
Professionally?
Yeah.
Rome, Flynn.
Not NBA. I mean, I could play overseas,
with
though.
The big three?
I would tear them boys up over there, man.
Stop!
They're too old.
Oh, my gosh. Lil Nate Robinson will eat you for lunch.
Nah, he should still be in the league somewhere.
He should be.
That dude
which
in
tells
shape.
You there's some politics going on.
Oh,
we're not going to get you involved in that conversation because you just new in your career. All right. Let me say all the bad things. All right. Springfield, Illinois.
Yeah.
Which, how close is that to Chicago?
2 hours, 2.5 hours.
Okay, so that's not your purview. So growing up in Springfield, tell me about this.
I was born in Chicago, and then we moved
when
I was younger. It was really bad when I was young in Chicago. I still remember, like, drive-bys and stuff like that, finding, like, needles sort of thing. Like, we lived in the projects when we was in Chicago. So I think in 1999 or 2000.
So what happened? Y'all had a Jefferson moment?
My mom, she just... She's a warrior, man. She's like, I got to get my family out of here. You know, she basically took all of us. And
how many of us
at that time? I think it was like 3 or 4 of us at the time. I don't know
how many Flynns are there.
Oh, there's 8 of us total.
Say what now?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not on the that's
not on Wikipedia. You know?
No, that's not. It's a hidden secret. That's right. Exclusive on the Carol Hunter Show.
Yeah.
There are 8 Flynns. Where do you fall in the birth order?
I'm second oldest.
Okay.
And the oldest boy.
The oldest boy. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So 7 brothers and sisters, and you're the oldest. What responsibility is on your shoulders?
I never felt like there was any because growing up, I understood early that that's what I had to be. I think that the pressure comes from you going into a situation that you're not familiar with. And so at a young age, I knew I was, you know, growing up, knowing I had to kind of lead the way for them. And, you know, my dad not being around as much at that time. It just kind of worked seamlessly. I don't know. Where was he? He was in Chicago. Was he? He may have been locked up or something. I'm not sure.
Just matter of fact, Okay, yeah. But there's eight of you, so yeah. Mom and dad were doing something.
Well, there's four of us, right? Four of us that have the same mom and dad. We okay. have the same mom and dad.
Okay.
And then my mom got remarried, okay. So she had other kids.
Okay.
So that's eight
so
of us.
So they're not eight Flynns. They're four Flynns.
Four.
I ain't getting involved in all that.
It's,
all
right, it's too bad. I don't even remember, honestly.
Let me move on, because it's getting uncomfortable for me. All right. So tell me about... The Madea family funeral. Is this Tyler Perry's last performance as Madea? Supposedly,
I believe so.
This is what he said. Yeah. Do you believe him?
I believe what he has to say. I believe him because he said it. It came out of his mouth, so I gotta believe it. You know, but I'm telling you what, he makes a lot of money doing these Madea films, and not that he needs any more. You know, he's killing it. But I think he wants to gear towards more doing other things. He wants to create more, and I'm sure doing Madea is just. It takes a lot of energy. I mean,
yeah,
he's been doing
imagine.
It for so long. It's
yeah.
just like, you know.
Those breasts are heavy. They
I
look
mean,
heavy.
He does like seven different characters in this movie.
That's right.
So
he plays the brother,
yeah.
the brothers, the son, the uncle, the brother.
He played all the relatives.
Yeah, the mother and Madea.
He was doing it before Eddie Murphy was.
That's okay. true. That's yeah. true. What's the biggest lesson you learned from Tyler Perry?
The biggest thing I learned from him was just being persistent and resiliency, man. And like I say, he was knocking on Hollywood's door for a long time. And they laughed him off, you know, he did his own thing. He did the play. And now it's like you can go anywhere and people know who Tyler Perry is. He's built his own empire. And, you know, I idolize that. And that's something I want. And whatever that means for me, I'm not sure yet. But the idea of having that creative control is important to me. So that's what I'm searching. Like, that's what I'm trying to get to.
How did you end up in his universe? There's a world. There's a Tyler Perry world where you work and you eat. He feeds his people.
He does. But I think that there's a difference with me. He's still one of my good friends, too, even on top of that. So he looked out for me. You know, and I did the Madea film with him first. And then, you know, he kind of pulled me aside and was like, hey, I want you to do this, have and have not show. Like, very popular. I think you'd be great on it. I didn't know if he was serious or not, you know. And then he called me. And he's like, "I'm. Let's talk about it. I'm writing this character." I'm like, "Wait. Who is this?" Like, he's like, "It's Tyler. It's Tyler Perry." I'm like, "What? I'm at the barber. I had to get out of the chair. You know, I had to go outside and talk about this character with him." And he's a very gracious, like, writer too. You know, like he for me anyway. Like my relationship with him, he was very cool with that. With me, like, you know, figuring out what we wanted to do with the character.
All right, so what's next for Rome Flynn? Are you back? Did they re-sign you for How to Get Away with Murder? Because something's happening with you.
I'm here, okay.
So what does that mean?
I ain't getting
Do you
rid
know,
of Rome.
Are you going to get killed in the last... Come on, tell us.
All right, I'm going to tell you the secret, all right? There is no secret. That's a secret.
All right, so maybe he'll be back next season, y'all. I don't know, but yeah. I'm enjoying the hell out of him on How to Get Away with Murder.
You.
And check him out in a Madea family funeral March 1st, that's right. And it's been a pleasure. We got to do this again. This is too
this
short
is so
they're
fun.
Telling me we got to
that's
break
it
us.
Oh
it,
man,
we could do this because I got more questions for you, Rome.
I like
I'll
it
ask them off mic. All right, it's the Karen Hunter Show. We'll be right back.